Hi everyone, Namaskar, this is TeleMedicine. Welcome to my health channel. Well, it's all over the news about a soccer team of 12 boys and their coach being trapped in a cave in Thailand named Tham Luang Cave since 23rd of June, and they were successfully rescued by 10th of July. I would like to congratulate those brave Wild Boars and Thai Navy SEALs and divers from various countries who risked their life for this rescue mission. I would like to especially mention about Dr. Richard Harris from Australia, who was taking medical care of the boys and gave all clear for each evacuation. As per the news, all those boys, the coach and the divers involved will remain quarantined in a hospital, and the doctors will investigate and look for signs and symptoms of infections. When people are trapped in a wet, dark and isolated place like cave for days, they are vulnerable to many health effects, as they could have been exposed to various infections like cave disease, leptospirosis, bat rabies, myeloidosis and post-traumatic disorder. So what is cave disease? In medical terms, it's known as histoplasmosis, also known as darling's disease. Well, it's not caused by your darling. It is caused by a dimorphic fungus known as Histoplasma capsularum, which is mainly found in the soil associated with the bat and the bird droppings, like in caves and the river banks. The infected soil can remain potentially infectious for many years, and the infection is usually transmitted by the airborne spores of the fungus, which enter our lungs during inhalation. The spores enter alveoli of the lungs and grow there, and they can spread to other organs through lymphatic circulation. 90% of patients are clinically asymptomatic, and the disease resolves without any treatment in immunocompetent individuals. If symptoms develop, then onset occurs within 3 to 14 days after exposure to fungus Histoplasma capsulatum. Fortunately, this infection is not contagious, means it's not transmitted from human to human. Symptoms include fever, chills, headache, body ache, malaise, abdominal pain and cough. In some patients, it can also cause chest pain, breathlessness and hemoptysis, that is expectoration or coughing up of blood. Cave disease or histoplasmosis can be classified into acute pulmonary histoplasmosis, chronic pulmonary histoplasmosis and progressive disseminated histoplasmosis, which occur mostly in immunocompromised patients like those who have AIDS, blood cancers, organ transplantation, patients on corticosteroids and infants. If proper treatment is not given, then the complications may arise like recurrent pneumonia, respiratory failure, pleural effusions, bronchiectasis, and fibrosing mediastinitis. In heart, it can cause pericarditis, endocarditis, and superior vena cava syndrome. In brain, it can cause mass lesion, encephalopathy, and meningitis. It can also cause presumed ocular histoplasmosis syndrome and retinal detachment and hemorrhage, which may subsequently lead to blindness. So how can you diagnose cave disease or histoplasmosis? In lab investigations, we can do CBC, that is complete blood count. Pancytopenia, that is decreased blood counts, may occur in 70 to 90% patients in acute progressive disseminated histoplasmosis. Alkaline phosphatase levels are increased in acute progressive disseminated histoplasmosis and chronic pulmonary histoplasmosis. Sputum cultures and blood cultures can be done to detect the fungus. Serum and urine antigen detection test by ELISA and PCR. It's a faster method of detection. Immunoprecipitating antibodies test. This test detects antibodies to glycoproteins H and M. Complement fixing antibodies test. In this test, titer is considered positive if reciprocal dilutions are more than 1:8. Exercise is done to find out changes in the lungs and chest. CT scan of the head is done to detect cerebral histoplasmosis, and CT abdomen is useful in detecting adrenal involvement. Echocardiography is done to detect any involvement of the heart. Now let's come to treatment part. Most infections in the immunocompetent individuals are self-limiting, and no therapy is required if asymptomatic. But in symptomatic acute pulmonary histoplasmosis, Medical therapy should be initiated with the antifungal drugs like itraconazole for 6 to 12 weeks. Patients should be monitored for several years for possible relapse. Another antifungal drug, amphotericin B, can be used in severe infections. Chronic pulmonary histoplasmosis is often fatal if not treated properly. The mortality rate may be as high as 50% without treatment, and patient may have progressive loss of pulmonary function. Surgical treatment may be required in patients with persistent lung cavitations. So how can we prevent cave disease or histoplasmosis? Well, we can do decontamination of the infected soil by 3% formalin solution, educate individuals about the exposure risk in endemic areas. Mask and respirators can be used. Water sprays can be done to decrease the dust formation. These are a few preventive measures which we can do while traveling in the endemic areas like riverbanks or caves. Finally, my best wishes to all those brave boys in Thailand. Hope they will come out soon from hospital hale and hearty. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button and share. Please do subscribe my health channel. See you again. Goodbye.